Good morning, Standard 9 students. Today I shall be teaching you Act 2, Scene 7. Now, how are you going to learn the drama is like this. You must memorize each act and each scene. So now we are in Act 2, Scene 7. Okay, where does the scene take place? The scene takes place in Belmont, a hall in Portia's house. Okay. Then again the question will be asked, suppose if the speaker is Portia, then they will ask, who else is present in the scene? So we have Portia, we have the Prince of Morocco, and they servants or trains. Okay. Now that includes Nerissa, and that is all Portia's gang. Portia's servants. Okay, Nerissa, her maid, and the other maid servants, and the Prince of Morocco with his train, meet with a group of attendants. Okay, who follows him wherever he goes. Or if the Prince of Morocco is the speaker, then the others that are present over here will be Portia, Nerissa, and their trains. Now, in this particular scene, the Prince of Morocco has come to take part in the lottery system. He has taken all the oaths, and now he has made a final decision that he will participate and he wants to win the hands of Portia. He loves her and he wants to win her over. Okay. So whatever formality had to be done in the previous scene, it has been done. Now we have come to that part where he takes the risk of choosing. Now he is going to choose the casket. Okay. So now the first part is Portia. She instructs one of the servants, go draw aside the curtains and discover the several caskets to this noble prince. She says, go remove the curtain and show the three caskets to this noble prince. Here she is being very courteous. With due respect, she is addressing the Prince of Morocco. Okay. Now make your choice. Then she tells the Prince of Morocco, now make your choice. You have been exposed to the three caskets, the golden casket, the silver casket, and the leaden casket. Now Morocco examines the casket. He's looking at the casket very hard. The first of gold, who this inscription bears? Now there is an inscription written on each casket. You have to memorize that inscription. The exact words that is written in the inscription. So what's written in the golden casket is, who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. So the inscription written in the golden casket is, whoever chooses me shall get what many men desire. That means we'll get something which is a great demand by so many people. The second silver, which this promise carries, who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. Now in the silver casket, the inscription written over there, whoever chooses me shall get as much as he deserves. The golden casket says, whoever chooses me shall get what many men desire. The silver casket says, as much as he deserves. The third, dull lead, with warning all as blunt. So the third casket is the leaden casket. It has got a dangerous inscription written. Who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath. The leaden casket says, whoever chooses me must give and take, or take and give whatever he possesses, means whatever he has. You have to take the risk of giving and taking. Okay, so he finds this inscription in the lead casket is very threatening, because you have to give and hazard all that you have. With all that you have to put it in a risk, take a big risk of all that you possess. Must give for what? Sorry. How shall I know if I do choose the right? So how will I know that I have chosen the right casket? Out of the three, which is the right one, how will I know? So Portia says, the one of them contains my picture. Prince, if you choose that, then I am yours with all. So one of the three caskets has a picture of mine. So if you choose the casket that has my picture, then I will be yours forever. Means I will be your wife. Okay. Then the Morocco's says, some God direct my judgment. Now remember, this choosing of the casket is a big risk. It all depends on your luck, whether your luck is good or not. So you are seeking for divine help, and God should come and help you choose or make the right choice. Let me see. I will survey the inscription back again. Now remember, he says, now let me see. I shall examine the casket again once more. First it was gold, silver and lead. Now he wants to examine it again, but this time he's going to go for lead, silver and gold. So now he's starting with the leaden casket. Who chooses me must give and hazard all he had. So now he is pondering, he's trying to reason out what the leaden casket is saying. Whoever chooses me shall give and hazard all he had. Then he says, must give for what? For what reason must I give? For lead, in return I will get lead. Lead is not so costly a metal like silver and gold. So if I take the risk, what will I gain from risking all that I have? For lead, hazard for lead. He's making fun. He said, take all the chances, take all the risk, just for lead. This casket threatens. Wow, Prabhupada, this is a threatening casket. Men that hazard all. Now, in general, he's talking, what is the general opinion of people who would love to take a risk? What is his expectation? What does he expect when he puts everything in a risk? Do it in hope of fair advantage. Whoever takes the risk, definitely he would want to have a better gain or profit. He will want something 10 times more than what he has put to risk. Unless the output is not very good, he is not going to put everything in a risk. Put all that he has in a risk. Then he says, a golden mine stoops not to shows of dross. So now a strong mind, okay, should not bend, should not stoop for something which is worthless. So here he considers the value of lead as worthless metal. It's a worthless metal. It is not as costly as silver and gold. So the value of lead is very less. So why should a golden mine bend, stoop for a useless metal? I will then no give, no hazard aught for lead. In that case, I am not going to give or take all the risk just to gain or get the benefit of lead, which is not a very valuable metal. Okay, I'll end it over here, then I shall explain the remaining part in the next class. And whatever notes I'll be sending, okay, it should be a little corresponding to your lesson that I taught. And I'll be sending the hard copy today, whatever I taught. Okay, read it. And again in the next class, you can clarify your doubts. Thank you.